E onei e gloria ki te atua tihe I Māori ora. Nau mai, hari mai, ki tēnei wharei karakia, tēnā koutou, tēnā tata katoa. Good morning, school. Very warm welcome to chapel this morning. If you are stood, please be seated. Welcome to our whae today on this fine Tuesday morning. Our thanks to Riley for playing that lovely hymn for us as we entered this morning. Here I am, Lord, and hopefully it won't be too long before we're back here belting out those great hymns together as a community sometime, we hope and pray, in term two. Today's theme is generosity. Generosity is being led for us by Chapel Prefect Emily this morning, and we look forward to her reflections and her words on this very important and very powerful theme. Let us go to our opening responses. The Lord be with you. This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Kia ora.
God, all love comes from you. Warm our hearts with your love. Deliver us from all meanness of spirit. And make us generous in all that we do and all that we are. Through Jesus Christ, our liberator, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. One God, now and forever. Amen.
In today's reading from Corinthians, Paul speaks about generosity. Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. Here ends the reading.
Story of the day. Long ago on Christmas Eve, Della discovers she has only $1.87 to buy a present for her husband Jim. She visits the nearby shop of a hairdresser who buys Della's long hair for $20. Della then uses the money to buy a platinum pocket watch chain for Jim. When her husband comes home from work that evening to discover the absence of Della's long, luscious hair, she reveals that she sold her hair to buy him the chain. Jim then hesitantly gives Della her present, a set of ornamental combs, which she will be unable to use until she grows her hair back out. Della gives Jim the watch chain, and he tells her that he sold the watch to buy the combs. While the gifts that Jim and Della gave each other cannot be used, they know how far they went to show their love for each other and how generous they are to put others before them.
The story that you just heard was a quick summary of The Gift of the Magi, a short story written by O. Henry in the 1900s. It exemplifies the importance to realize that acts of generosity are unconditional. They are not only for those you love, but for everyone else too. Although it's ironic that Della and Jim gifted each other those gifts, it was the act of the sacrifice that demonstrates one's ability to be selfless. Of course, there are many ways to be generous. Giving materials is one. However, giving is not just with money or materialistic items. It's about the actions that come from the heart. It's sharing what we have and what we are. And unlike the sharing of materials, the gift of time and kindness is priceless. By taking a portion of your time and giving it to people you care about makes them feel accepted and helps them be confident that there are people out there who look out for them. It takes a special part of your heart to achieve generosity, requiring will and courage to put others before yourself. At school, we see many opportunities in service to be generous with those who are disadvantaged in the community. Yet being generous doesn't mean you have to give your all every second of every day. Really, all it needs is a little thoughtfulness to light the spark of someone else's day. As Daniel mentioned in the reading earlier, St. Paul states that whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. St. Paul urges his followers to remember that what you give will be what you receive. If all of us were generous and kind to each other, they would remember and repay you with the same compassion you want to receive. The cliche, treat others how you want to be treated, illustrates this well. Similarly, someone who takes advantage of their gifts and never gives will find it hard to take the first step in giving. So I urge you to start sowing seeds from this day, even if it's just the smallest of seeds. Don't be afraid to be like Della or Jim, who have put others above their most prized possessions. Of course, our gestures do not have to be big for a great impact. It could be offering someone a hand with their homework if they've been away in isolation, or perhaps saying hello to the new students of the school who are immersing themselves in St. Paul's culture. Because people will notice your generosity, the more seeds you sow, the more rewards and happiness you will reap. When St. Paul passed on the teachings of Jesus and said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive," we now should understand how remarkably true the statement is. That's because giving starts with a generous heart and a generous soul. It's obvious, but how is it obvious? Telling someone to do something is a lot easier than doing it yourself, which is why a mindset of giving cannot be forced by another. Instead, it's a journey that you begin yourself, and it's a journey that only those who put their virtues into it can complete. The year 2022 is busier than ever. With term one ending so soon, time seems like it's slipping out of our grips, and we haven't had a chance to settle, appreciate, and acknowledge the kind acts around us. Lots of us are left in limbo with the lack of service opportunities able to run. But I urge you, do not despair when service programs are postponed or when over the fence is temporarily on hold. Because if kindness comes from within, then why not start within our community? I suggest that we begin with ourselves and the people directly beside us. Today, I wish to give you a task that hopefully and surely everybody can do. I challenge you to put someone else before you. For example, one that is often said the most is to hold the door for someone else, or sparing your time and picking up a piece of neglected rubbish. These little things, although small, have a much greater effect on our community and the people around us. It is certainly difficult to juggle multiple things at the same time, and I'm sure many of you will also notice this. With the to-do list getting longer and longer, it becomes much harder to spare some time for other people. It is difficult to be generous when you need to help yourself first. During these trying times, it's important to remind ourselves that the people around you need you. A talk with your stressed friend may be the thing that they needed to be motivated again. Although counterintuitive, our small gestures can flourish. Always remember that the will that came from your heart will warm theirs too. So be bold and take that first step. Thank you.
So some music's gonna be played very shortly, and there it is now. And during that music, or during this time, the opportunity to think through Emily's message or to have a discussion in your mentor group. We could drop the volume a little bit while I'm talking. Something's gone wrong there. Anyway, so a chance to discuss and a chance to think and reflect this morning just for a few minutes.
Thank you. In prayer. God of life and love, we give you thanks for your generosity revealed to us in the many gifts we find in creation. For all that we experience and share amongst ourselves, and above all, your gift of love revealed and expressed in the life of Jesus. Thank you for all the many acts of generosity that have benefited and blessed our lives. Inspire us and help us today to be generous with our time, our gifts, our talents, and our skills. May your spirit of generosity flow through us and continue to build a better and brighter world for us all. In Jesus' name, amen. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we pray together in English. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We now have time for a silent prayer and reflection.
Kia ora. Okay, we'll just go to the next slide. Just want to say a few words in respect of what Emily gifted to us, a generous gift of her own time and skill and talent as she created that, thought through that, and produced that, and delivered that for us this morning. Thank you, Emily, for that. A really special reflection, and certainly lots in there to think through and to unpack, and it will be a bit like some of the other words we've had spoken from this space over the last few weeks on that YouTube channel for further engagement with as well. Of course, all of us know what it is to be poor. In fact, most of us are incredibly poor. We live in abject poverty most of our lives. Of course, I'm not talking about finances or economics here. I'm talking about time. We are a culture that have to address the issue of time poverty. We don't have time. We are poor in time. And Emily's reflection made me think about how we gift our time. And time is such a precious gift, not only for ourselves, but also how we share that and how we gift that to others as well. Particularly somebody we notice who might be in need. Particularly for someone who might just need someone to talk to, a shoulder to cry on. Someone who might just need some time to make their life and their situation better. So I challenge us all not just to think about our gifts of money and our gifts of skill and talent, but also how we are generous with our time, particularly when it's so sacrificial because we have so little time ourselves. So let's just take Emily's words to heart and think about how generous we are as individuals and those who might need us to be a little bit more generous with our time alongside our other gifts and skills for them at this time. So thank you, Emily, for that, for challenging us and laying that before us today. So if we could go to the next slide, let's pray God's blessing upon us as we depart this house of prayer into the day that lies ahead. We're a little bit early today. I don't often say that in chapel, which is obviously a product of not singing and others taking the service and not me talking for too long, perhaps. Never mind, we'll soon be back to normal next term, that everybody will be delighted to know. Henceforth, we've got a few minutes so you can continue those conversations in your mental groups until the first bell goes. So let us bow our heads where we are and pray God's blessing upon us. So may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon us, those whom we love, those we care for, and especially those in need of our time and our skills, our talents, and our treasures today. Amen. So let's conclude the service with the words of the grace of St. Paul. Kia tō, kia tātou katoa. Te atawhai o tātou rariki a ihu karaiti. Me te aroha o te atua, me te whiwhina taitanga, ki te wairuru tapu, ake, 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 amene. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all forever and ever. Amen. So let's go in the love of God, the peace of Christ, and the dignity of the Holy Spirit. Kia kaha, kia hari, kia tapu, kia atawhai. Be strong, be happy, be holy, be kind. Amen. Thank you, Mr. Osborne.